Well, here we are, ladies and gentlemen, for today's 1 point Japanese cultural lesson. What you're seeing here is an eco toilet, a self-sufficient eco toilet, which you can see here is powered by a little windmill and solar panel there that's collecting the sun rays. Let's have a look. You can see the building itself is covered with green vines to reduce the absorption of heat. Solar panels there on the roof, and the roof, I might add, is also collecting rainwater to be used externally here from the little faucet. Let's go in and see the men's room. This is the short one here. This is just the urinal. And on the ceiling, you can see the lighting and the fan, which is operated by the electricity from the solar power. And let's see what we have over here. Oh, another men's toilet. Let's see what's in here. This is the traditional Japanese style toilet, again with lighting and fans. And let's see what else. Oh, we do have the handicapped and disabled toilet here. Let's have a look inside, make sure no one's doing their thing. You can see the handicapped bars there for support purposes, and wow, they even have a diaper changing bed there. How about that? That's cool. And let's see what else do we have. No, I don't think we're gonna go over there today. Anyways, it's a beautiful eco toilet here alongside the banks of the Edogawa, and it's quite a beautiful day today. Anyways, beautiful day for cycling. And, how can you not be impressed with a self-sufficient indoor toilet? And, I would be remiss not to sign off here by showing you the mean machine. This is my 18-speed Spalding mountain bike, which set me back about $170 4 years ago. Fully equipped with a World Cup soccer bike horn. Anyways, thank you very much for joining us. And this is your host, the Wolfman, signing off. Talk to you again soon. Goodbye.